Hey, wadau, natumai mko poa, mko salama, nawakaribisha tena sana. Na kwa sasa nataka tumzungumzie msanii Samido pamoja na mtangazaji kutokea katika kituo cha redio cha Kameme FM Modhoni wa Kirumba. So sit down and let's embrace this. As of right now, utakubaliana na mimi Samido, kama jinsi ambavyo mmeona kuna uwezekano wa Samido kuweza kujitosa katika siasa za mwaka 2027. But the question is Samido treading on the right path ikifikia soa kuingia katika siasa? One thing and a clear indication, you know what, that Samido has been preparing for this, wale ambao watapinga ya kwamba Samido hawezi ingia katika siasa, ni Samido recently, asoa ilikuwa ni tarehe za hivi majuzi. I want to give you the actual date ambazo Samido aliweza ku graduate. And this is not something that is coming out of the blues, kwa sababu msanii Samido hivi majuzi aliweza kupokea shahada yake kutokea katika chuo kikuu cha Jomo Kenyatta, cha Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture, which is JKUAT. And this means that now the man has the credentials za kuweza ku run for a political seat in the country. I am reminding you that as of 5 days ago, ikiwa ni aswa tarehe 28 mwezi Juni, Samido graduated from JKUAT with a degree ambayo alikuwa akisomea chini ya maji. I mean, sio wengi ambao walikuwa wakijua kwamba Samido was standing, sio wengi ambao walikuwa wakijua Samido ya kwamba alikuwa anapokea shahada yake. Let me tell you, Samido took it upon himself kuamua kuendeleza na kukamilisha masomo yake. Also not forgetting that the guy has a very decorated portfolio ya kuweza kumkubalia kupewa stakabadhi ya zuasa kuwania kiti cha ubunge eneo lolote lile. Recently, news of it that Samido aliweza kuwa moved from Nairobi, where he was stationed as a police officer, na akaweza kurelocatiwa to Nyeri, which is the stronghold ya naibu rais wa Jamhuri ya Kenya Rigathi Gachagua. So let's get down into it, tuingie tuweze kuchambua what might come of Samido the year 2027. Nikukumbusha, Samido launched his foundation, the Samido Foundation, last year, na pale alipata ku launch foundation ya kwake. A lot of people attended that, and most of them were politicians kutokea katika eneo la Mlima Kenya. We all know, ukifikia kutaja wasanii ambao wamefanikiwa sana katika eneo la Mlima Kenya, jina nambari moja litakalo kujia akilini ni jina lake Samido. Yes, because he is the maestro of Mogithi, he is the king of Mogithi. And you know what? Putting his music aside, the guy has been planning and preparing himself to run for office come the year 2027. As of right now, mumegundua ya kwamba Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua amekuwa na vita sana na wanasiasa wenzake kutokea katika eneo la Mlima Kenya ambao wamekuwa kimpinga due to his ambitions. But also artists, kuna wale ambao wameanza kujitenga-tenga na naibu wa rais. But one thing with Samido, he has stayed on the right side of DP Rigathi Gachagua, kwa sababu anajua, you know what, if I want to go for this thing, I have to have the right man on my side. And the right man right now in the Mount Kenya region is Rigathi Gachagua. Not forgetting that Rigathi Gachagua also is a very great friend to Samido Mushoki. Na with Gachagua's endorsement for Samido to run for any political seat, kwa sababu hawezi amka leo aseme ana run for governor, but him running for a political seat like an MP or a senator, ni haraka sana kuweza kuwahi kile kiti, because you know what, this guy is loved by many. But let me ask, do you think that Samido once get into the political arena ataweza kubadilika kama jinsi ambavyo wengine tuliowaweka pale waliweza kubadilika? Truth be told, the man will be in the papers come the year 2027. This is not a rumor. This is something that we all have looked at in an analytical perspective. Na tumeona ya kwamba Samido will be running for a political seat. And I tell you, mostly he will be running for an MP seat come the year 2027. Now, he is prepared mentally, socially, and also politically. We all saw that Juzi, when the president was having a cabinet meeting which was scheduled to happen, the DP wasn't there. The DP was at the burial of his sister. Na pale katika mazishi ya dadake, not many attended, mostly the politicians. Also artists, not many were there, but Samido was there. And he was given a chance. Let me tell you what happens when Samido is having a concert that involves all the political bigwigs in the country. Wakati huyu jamaa anapopanda stage, we as the people of Mount Kenya region lazima tuzushe nyavu. Na tunazusha nyavu kiasi gani? We all put everything aside and the national anthem of the Republic of Kenya is played before Samido enters the stage because he represents the Mount Kenya music. He is a representation of the music from the mountain. Yeah, apart from him who are prepared also in terms of finances and mentally, socially, the guy has been dating Senator Karen Nyamu. So Karen Nyamu is his second wife. And although rumor has it that they parted ways, but Samido has learned a lot from this woman, how she goes out for it. And right now she is a nominated senator who has direct touch with the president of the Republic of Kenya, William Ruto. Now, be sure that Samido will be in the ballot papers come the year 2027. Tukiweka Samido aside, I also told you of Muthoni wa Kirumba. Mumeona jinsi Muthoni amekuwa na DP. Mumeona how Muthoni wa Kirumba also is a darling to the deputy president of the Republic of Kenya. And let me tell you, this woman, munasemanga Gathoni wa Mushomba. You know, Gathoni ni mtu ambaye amwezi mwambia kitu kama anaona hii kitu haifai for the people of the Republic of Kenya. So Muthoni wa Kirumba is even more than Gathoni. And Muthoni wa Kirumba has the credentials. She has studied, she has a degree. And you know what? With that, she can table a credentials and also make it clear to the public, you know what, I will be running. And remember that Muthoni right now is dating also one of the biggest bigwigs in the Mount Kenya region, music. That is Waithaka wa Jeni. Muthoni wa Kirumba before, acha niwambie aka story. Before kitambo, ilikuwa ni vigumu sana kuweza kumuona wa Kirumba akiapia in public events. Yeah, attending music launches, attending political things ambazo ajalipwa kuattend ama zile ambazo azimuhusishi direct in one way or the other. But recently, you all have seen that Muthoni wa Kirumba has been involved with a lot of these things directly. So it's a clear indication that Muthoni is ready now to get into the political space. And she will be running for political seat. And I tell you, Nyandarua, the MPs in Nyandarua, you should be ready that, you know what? It will be a rough road for you come the year 2027, kama when MP wa mali ambapo Muthoni atakuwa kiran. Because I tell you, it will be very hard for you to beat this woman. And we all have decided, you know what? It's about time we do a change. It's about time tupanguze uchafu wote ambao umekuwa pale National Assembly kwa bunge kuu, watu ambao they have nothing to give to the people of the Republic of Kenya. And by saying that, I mean, you know what? This lady is a darling to the people of the Mount Kenya region. I tell you, ikija kwa radio presenters of right now in the Mount Kenya region, tell me somebody that surpasses the portfolio of Muthoni wa Kirumba to represent the people in the National Assembly. Tell me, name one. Nobody. Because this woman You know what? She's loved. And all I can say, between the two people, I tell you, their relationship with the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya, Rigathi Gachagua, gives them a direct nomination from the DP. And if the DP has endorsed them to run in certain places, I bet they will be kicking out those people that are representing those constituencies come the year 2027. Yes, you know what? All we can say is that we want a change in parliament. We want a change in government. And the change starts from somewhere. And I tell you, according to the analysis that we have done, Muthoni wa Kirumba will be a candidate in the 2027 polls. And also, yeah, I know right now it's so early for you to look at it in that perception, but kitu kimoja ambacho utagundua, our watu, they have built their portfolio. They have built their relationship with the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya. So, them getting there, it's not by coincidence. It's something that they have planned. I tell you, I shall remind you that Ruto started preparing to become the President of the Republic of Kenya since the year 2018. He campaigned for 5 years. Knowing, you know what, the big goal is mimi nitaongoza inchi yake. And that came to pass. So, mimi nitaiachia hapo na kukumbusha hii ni FM Shoki. Ipo pote ulipo usisahau kusubscribe. Tell me, if these people are brought and they are running in your constituencies, are you going to choose them? Are you going to elect them? We want to know that. Leave your comment in the comment section. See you in the next video. This is FM Show KE.